We will discuss about the so many topics and very very important topics, that is nucleus and cell wall, and what is the functions of nucleus and what is the functions of cell wall. Okay, another one is cell organelles. Very important cell organelles are present inside the cytoplasm of the cell. They are mitochondria, Golgi mitochondria, endoplasmic reticulum, plastids, and types of plastids. What is the types of endoplasmic reticulum? And now we are going to discuss about the main important cell organelle. It is one of the most important cell organelle, that is the Golgi apparatus or Golgi body, and it is also called as Golgi apparatus and Golgi body and Golgi complex. Okay, now let us study. First, the Golgi apparatus and Golgi complex were observed by the scientist Camillo Golgi. Who is the scientist? Camillo Golgi. In the year of 1898, he discovered the Golgi complex in the year of 1898. His name is given to his cell organelle. Okay. Who was discovered the Golgi complex? Camillo Golgi. Camillo Golgi. And his name is given to the cell organelle, that is the Golgi complex or Golgi body. Next, what is the structure of Golgi apparatus and Golgi body and Golgi complex? Okay, these are the vesicle and sac like structures found inside the cytoplasm of the cell. So here we can see that vesicles. Sir, share each other. Oh, okay, sir. Sac like structures. So these sac like structures are bound to fluid filled vesicles. The vesicles are filled with fluid. Okay. These vesicles and sac-like structures found inside the cytoplasm of the cell. So here we can see that vesicles and sac-like structures. So the sac-like structures are bound to fluid-filled vesicles. And what is the function of Golgi apparatus or Golgi complex? We studied about the endoplasmic reticulum. Okay, first we have to study about the who is discovered the Golgi apparatus and Golgi body. Slide kanipista unda andariki?
Kanipiledu madam.
Kanipileda?
Ledu madam.
Ippudu?
Ledu madam, kanipiledu madam.
Ana. ఎవరు అక్కడ పాట పాడేది స్లైడ్ ఇప్పుడు కనిపిస్తా ఉందా
కనిపిస్తా ఉంది కనబడుతుంది మేడం
ఇప్పుడు ఇప్పుడు కనిపిస్తుంది మేడం
కనబడుతుంది
కనబడుతుంది మేడం కనబడుతుంది మేడం
ఓకే ఓకే The discovery of Golgi apparatus. The Golgi apparatus was discovered by Camillo Golgi. Who is the scientist?
Camillo Golgi. Golgi.
In the year of 1898. And investigation of the nervous system. It is electron microscope structure was described by the Dalton and Flex in the year of 1954. This scientist also the study of the Golgi apparatus. And next one, this is organelle. It is also made up of several membranes. Plastids also made up of several membranes and endoplasmic reticulum also made up of several membranes and we studied about the endoplasmic reticulum. The endoplasmic reticulum produced like proteins, enzymes for different things are prepared here. Prepare here that means to prepare the proteins and enzymes in the Golgi complex.
Okay.
So these things are transported to these Golgi complex. All materials are transported to the Golgi apparatus of the cell. Golgi apparatus of the cell for the purpose of packing and distribution. Packing and distribution. So the major part taken up by these Golgi complex packing and distribution of materials that they are produced here in the endoplasmic reticulum.
Reticulum.
In the endoplasmic reticulum.
Reticulum.
So these enzymes are proteins and other materials are packed. They are slightly altered. Packed and slightly altered. A little bit modification takes place in the Golgi apparatus. Okay. After the modifications, they are packed and sent to lysosomes. They are packed and sent to
lysosomes.
All materials are packed in the Golgi apparatus and sent to the
lysosomes.
Okay, the number of Golgi bodies varies from one cell to another cell. The number of Golgi bodies varies from one cell to another cell.
Okay.
All cells that do not have same Golgi complex, the number is vary from one cell to another cell. Okay. Some of these cells, especially the cells parts which involved in the process of secretion like glands. The gland secretion by the hormones. The glands secreted by the hormones. That is, for example, adrenal. That is the gland. Adrenal is the gland. It secretes the adrenaline hormone. That is the fight and flight hormone. Just say example. Okay. We take pancreas. Okay. Pancreas or we take salivary glands. The salivary glands secrete the salivary amylase. That is the enzyme. So in these cases, the cells, they contain more number of Golgi bodies. The cells have more number of Golgi bodies because the Golgi bodies, they involve in the function of secretion. Packing and producing the different enzymes and proteins. So the organs which involve in the function of secretion. That means the pancreas secrete the pancreatic juice. Okay, next, the salivary glands. The salivary glands secrete the ptyalin or salivary amylase. That is the enzyme. Okay, see the slide. This organelle is also made up of several membranes. Plastids are also made up of several membranes. And mitochondria are also made up of the two membranes and chloroplast. These are all the made up of several membranes. That is, one part is the Golgi apparatus or Golgi
apparatus.
Next, these membranes create sac-like structures around mainly fluid-filled vesicles. That is the sac-like structures. This is the vesicles. Okay. This is the fluid-filled vesicles. Next. it's an organelle found in the most eukaryotic cells. What is a eukaryotic cells? That is having nucleus and nuclear membrane. That is having nucleus and nuclear membrane. Membrane bounded nucleus and membrane bounded nuclear membrane. Okay. Next, the proteins and other substances produced in the ribosome reaches the Golgi body through the vesicles. Proteins and other substances produced the ribosomes, okay, and reaches the Golgi apparatus through these vesicles. Next one, the number of Golgi bodies varies from cell to cell. They do not have same number of Golgi bodies all the cells. The number of Golgi bodies are different from cell to cell. Okay. Next, the number is particularly large in those cells that secrete hormones and enzymes. That is, hormones means, for example, adrenal, that is the gland, and it secretes the adrenaline hormone, and the salivary glands secrete the salivary amylase and or ptyalin to secrete the enzymes and hormones. Next one, the Golgi body. The Golgi body is packed to various substances before they are transported to other parts of the cell. The Golgi body is packing of substances, and they transport the different parts of the cell. Next one, from here these substances are either sent towards the cell membrane or to another organelle, the lysosome. These substances, that means all the packing of various substances, are sent to the towards the cell membrane or another cell organelle, that is the lysosome, to send to the packing of various substances, lysosomes. Next one is, after reaching the cell membrane, these substances are secreted from the cell. After reaching the cell membrane, all these substances are secreted from the cell and sometimes even used to regenerate and repair the membrane. Regenerate means and repair the cell membrane. Next one is, functions of Golgi body. What is the functions of Golgi body? Functions of Golgi bodies: the materials synthesized near the endoplasmic reticulum is dispatched to various target sites inside the outside through the Golgi apparatus. They produced the packing of materials are distributed to the all parts of the cell. The packing of material distributed to the all parts of the cell or next another cell organelle, that is the lysosome. Next, it function as the storage and modification and packing of products in vesicles. Next, the Golgi bodies are also involved in the conversion of complex sugar into simple sugars. Golgi bodies are the next another function is it is converted to simple complex sugar is converted into simple sugars. The complex sugars is converted into simple sugars. Next, the functions of the Golgi apparatus. Next, another important cell organelle, that is the lysosome. Next, very important cell organelle, that is the lysosome. So what are these lysosomes? Now we are discussed about the Golgi bodies in which the materials that are to be distributed and sent out. So those materials are packed and sent to the lysosomes. That is the another important cell organelle. All the substance are packing to the Golgi body and distributed to the next important cell organelle, that is the lysosome. So the lysosomes consist of destroying enzymes or destructive enzymes. It consists of destroying enzymes or destructive enzymes. So the destroyed enzymes are there inside the lysosome. The destroyed enzymes are, where is it present? It is present inside the lysosomes. Mm-hmm. Earlier, when the scientists do not know about the lysosomes, they identify some destroying enzymes inside the cell. They identify the destructive enzymes inside the cell. They do not know that these destroyed enzymes carried by the lysosomes. So they thought that it was mystery for the scientist how a cell is able to destroying enzymes without collapsing, without getting destroyed. How the cell is mystery destroying the enzymes without collapsing, without getting destroyed. So they identify some substances or which can be destroyed in the cell. But nothing happens to the cell organelles. When the cell is a living state, so it was a mystery. So later they found that this destroying or these destructive enzymes are not directly present in the cytoplasm. Okay. If they're found directly in the cytoplasm, they come in contact with the mitochondria. They may be come in contact with the nucleus. They may be come in contact with the other organelle. or other cell organelles. Okay, and they may be digest them, and they may digest them. So the cell will be died. The cell will be died.
Died.
So that is not happening because these destructive enzymes, these destructive enzymes are not openly found in the cytoplasm and not directly found in the cytoplasm of the cell. They are not coming directly. They are not coming directly contact with the cell organelle. They are coming contact with the mitochondria, contact with the nucleus, and contact with the another cell organelles. Another cell organelles. These destroying enzymes are packed and safely in the lysosome. These destructive enzymes are packedly saved in the lysosomes. It is a stored part of the destructive enzymes. It is stored part of the destructive enzymes. So the lysosomes, even though it is carry destroying enzymes, those are not directly coming in contact with the different parts of the cell. Directly contact with the different parts of the cell. These lysosomes, they carry the materials inside the cell and they carry the materials out. They carry the material inside the cell and they carry the materials inside the outside the cell. Okay, sometimes when the cell wanted to destroy itself, the cell is wanted to destroy itself, the lysosomes burst open up and these toxic materials enter the cell and they destroy the cell. The toxic materials are enter into the cell will be destroyed. Okay, so that is the reason why the lysosomes are called as suicidal bags. The lysosomes are contain destructive enzymes, the stored the destructive enzymes. So it is called as suicidal bags of the cell. The lysosomes are also called as suicidal bags of the cell. Next, observe the next slide. Lysosomes, it is a membrane bounded organelle. It is also membrane bounded organelle. Next, that contain digestive enzymes or destructive enzymes or destroying enzymes. Next, lysosomes are involved with various cell processes. It is also involved in the various cell processes. Next, they break down excess or worn out cell parts. Worn out cell parts. Next, they may be used to destroy invading viruses and bacteria. The bacteria and viruses also, it is destroying. It is destroying. Next, this is the lysosomes. This is the lysosome. Next.
Madam, remaining 5 minutes in madam time.
Sir, in 15 minutes, pattern, sir.
Babu, cut out the 40 minutes.
Cut out what? That is, Malli, one sir, Malli, connect up and under catch tanga.
Healing to the next. Lies. Healing to the next. Jana wala under. Okay na. Surya, Pranay Kumar.
Okay
na.
Sir. Okay sir.
Next, lysosomes were discovered as tiny particles visible in the cytoplasm. All cell organelles are present in the cytoplasm of the cell. All cell organelles are present in the cytoplasm of the cell. Next. It was found that they contain the destructive enzymes, digestive enzymes and destructive enzymes are
destructive enzymes.
Next, these enzymes do not come in contact with the rest of the cell. Do not directly contact with the cell. They may be contact with the mitochondria, nucleus, and other cell organelles. The materials that need to be destroyed are transported to the lysosomes. Some materials are need to be destroyed and transported to the next cell organelle, that is the lysosome. Next, then the lysosomes get them digested at times. All the materials are digested to the lysosomes. Next, the lysosomes burst and the enzymes are released to digest the cell. The cell may be safe. Next, hence lysosomes are also known as the suicidal bags of the cell. Why it is called as suicidal bags of the cell? The lysosomes are contain destroying enzymes or destructive enzymes and digestive enzymes. Okay, so that's why it is called as suicidal bags of the cell. This is the lysosomes. This is the lysosomes. All cell organelles. The all cell organelles. Mr. Surya, see the slide. This cell, all cell organelles. This is the mitochondria. This is the endoplasmic reticulum. And vacuoles. And Golgi apparatus. Lysosomes, ribosomes. These are all the present inside the cytoplasm of the cell. Okay, next. Lysosomes. What is the function of lysosomes? It contains powerful digestive enzyme. It contains powerful digestive enzymes and digest food particles to release nutrients to the cell. The lysosomes digest in the food particles and releases to the nutrients to the cell. Next, digesting food and digesting organelles, that is the mitochondria, and digesting cells, that is the cell membrane. And next slide, lysosomes. This is the lysosomes. This is the endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, ribosomes, lysosomes, nucleus, vacuoles. That is the next another important cell organelle, that is the vacuole. Let us do an activity. What is the aim of activity? To observe the vacuoles in succulent plant like torch cactus. That is the plant is torch cactus. Next. Required materials. Required materials. Cactus, watch glass, water, dilute saponin solution, microscope. This is the cactus. Microscope. Water. This is the saponin solution. Okay. Next. Procedure. What is the procedure to make a activity? Next. First, take the leaf or stem of any succulent plant, that is torch cactus.
Class continue karandi ya cut aipothundi malli aalinku thane meer join avandi appude.
Ah sir 15 minutes pattern sir.
Ah sare.
Next, take 16 cross section of stem of cactus in a watch glass containing water. Take the stem.
కంటిన్యూ చేయండి మేడం, రాసుకుంటాం.
స్లైడ్ కనిపిస్తా ఉందా?
కనబడుతుంది మేడం.
ఫస్ట్ ద ఎయిమ్ ఆఫ్ ది ఎక్స్పెరిమెంట్ ఈస్ టు అబ్జర్వ్ ది వాక్యూ ఎనీ సక్యులెంట్ ప్లాంట్ దట్ ఈస్ ద క్యాక్టస్
టార్చ్ క్యాక్టస్
Required materials,
water,
torch cactus plant, next, watch glass, microscope, and that is the lysosomes, vacuoles, to observe the vacuoles in succulent plant. This is the required material and procedure. Take the leaf or stem of any succulent plant, that is the torch cactus. Next, take thin cross section of stem of cactus in a watch glass or containing water. Next, stain it with the dilute saffronin solution. Next, observe the section under low and high power microscopes, that is the compound microscope. This is the vacuole. Kanipista unda? This is the
anvardhan madam.
Next, result. The large empty spaces is vacuole. This is the large, and all are see the slide. This is the large empty spaces. This is the vacuole. The large empty spaces present in the cell are vacuole. This is the plant cell. This is the vacuole. These are fluid-filled sac-like structures. In animal cells, vacuoles are small in size. To compare to the plant cell, the animal cell contains vacuoles. It is small in size. Next. While in plant cells, they might occupy almost of the entire the cell space. It is almost of occupy the cell space. That is the biggest cell organelle. Next, vacuoles maintain turgor pressure within the cell. Next, they export unwanted substances from the cell. It is exported to unwanted substances from the cell. Next, this is the vacuole. This is the plant cell and this is the animal cell. The vacuole is almost all occupy the entire space of the cell, and this is the vacuole. It is very small in animal cell. Next, plant cell and animal cell. Next, are all cells are flat or not? The image of cells appear flat and two dimensional shape. Okay, they do not, all cells are flat. It is also two dimensional shape and three dimensional shape. In reality, the cells have length, breadth and thickness, as we cannot see the thickness under the microscope. Only we can see the cell organelle with the help of microscope, and we cannot see the length and breadth and thickness of the cells. Next, this three dimensional image become clear if you reduce the intensity of light. Reduce the intensity of light. This is the three dimensional cells and this is the two dimensional cell. This is the cytoplasm and this is the vacuole, cell membrane, nucleus, chloroplast. Next, three-dimensional pictures of the cell. This is the three-dimensional pictures of the cell. Next, where do cells come from? All cells come from pre-existing cells, the division of cell division, the process of cell division, that is the mitosis and that is the meiosis. See the slide. All living beings are made up of cells. For every living organism is made up of cells, and that each cell has a nucleus. All these cells contain nucleus. Next, two scientists expressed this in the form of theory. Who has proposed the cell theory? Who is proposed cell theory? Next, the scientists were Matthias Jakob Sladen and Theodor Schwann. The two scientists proposed the cell theory. Theodor Schwann and Sladen. Sladen was a botanist while Schwann was a zoologist. Next, Sladen and Schwann together formulated the cell theory. The two scientists joined together to form the cell theory. He is the Matthias Jakob Sladen and he is the Theodor Schwann. Next, Matthias, he is the botanist. Theodor Schwann, he is the zoologist, concluded that all the animals are made up of cells. All living beings are made up of cells. he proposed Theodor Schwann and Jacob Matthias Jacob Sladen to join together to form the cell theory. Next, this theory, however, did not explain as to how the cells were come from, how the cell new cells were formed. He did not explain who did not explain the cell theory. Next, Rudolf Carl Virchow first explained that the new cells could be formed only by the division of the pre-existing cells, only by the division of the cell division and pre-existing cells. He is the Rudolf Virchow. Next, Schwann, Sladen and Virchow. These two scientists formed the cell theory, and Rudolf Virchow was the new cells were come from the pre-existing cells. He find that the new cells were come from the pre-existing cells. That means old cells. Okay, next, that is the cell theory. Matthias Jacob Sladen, all plants are made up of cells. It is plants are also living beings. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
And Theodor Schwann was concluded that all animals are made up of cells. And Rudolf Virchow, all cells came from the pre-existing cells. These three scientists joined together to form the cell theory. Next one. This is also cell theory. All living organisms are composed of one or more cells. Single cell organisms are multicellular organisms. The cell is the basic structural and functional unit of living organism. What is the structural and functional unit of living organisms?
Cell.
Very good. Next, cell arises from the new cells arises from the pre-existing cells.
Pre-existing.
By the cell division, that is the mitosis or meiosis. Next, being of cell theory, he is the botanist. He is the Sladen and Schwann. Cell theory as understood today is based on the two cardinal principles. That is the all living organisms are composed of cells and products of cells. And all cells are arises from the pre-existing cells. Next, important point. First, the fundamental organizational unit of life is the cell. That is the basic and structural and functional unit of all living beings. It is the most important. Next, cells are enclosed by the plasma membrane composed of lipids and proteins. All cells are enclosed by the plasma membrane or cell membrane. Plasma membrane or cell membrane composed of lipids. The plasma membrane or cell membrane are composed of lipids and proteins. Next, plasma membrane is a selectively permeable membrane. Why it is called a selectively permeable membrane? It allows some selected substances through this membrane and enter into the cell and leave out of the cell. That's why it is called as a selectively permeable membrane. The plasma membrane or cell membrane is selected some substances. Next, in plant cells, a cell wall is composed of cellulose is located outside the cell membrane. The extra layer is cell wall. It is made up of cellulose. It is made up of cellulose. Next, in prokaryotes, nuclear membrane is absent, and eukaryotes, the nuclear membrane and nucleus is present. Next, the endoplasmic reticulum functions both as passageway for intracellular transport and manufacturing surface of the protein and lipids. Next, lysosomes are membrane bounded sac filled with digestive enzymes are and destructive enzymes, destroying enzymes. Next, the Golgi apparatus consists of stacks of the membranes bounded vesicles that function in the storage. All the substances are packing and storage of the vesicles. Next, mitochondria are also known as powerhouses of the cell. Why it is called as powerhouses of the cell? Why it is called powerhouses of the cell? Anyone?
It uses respiratory to all parts of the cell.
It is responsible for the
respiratory
cellular respiration, that is the aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Next, three types of plastids are present in the cell: chromoplastids, chloroplasts, and leukoplastids. స్క్రీన్ కనిపిస్తా ఉందా?
మేడం కనబడుతుంది మేడం.
వీడియో వాట్సాప్ లో పంపిస్తాను చూడండి. ఓకే సార్, తులసి వీడియో వాట్సాప్ లో పంపిస్తాను చూడండి అందరు. సార్ తులసి సార్ ఎంతసేపు ఉంది సార్ టైమింగ్ ఇంకా?
మేడం ఉంది మేడం, అదే 40 మినిట్స్ కదా, అయితే చెప్తాను మేడం.
ఏం సార్?
ఇంకా 20 మినిట్స్ ఉంది మేడం.
టైం ఉందా ఇంకా?
ఉంది మేడం, ఉంది మేడం, ఇంకా టైం ఉంది.
ఓకే సార్, ఓకే సార్. సరే సార్, నేను ఒక వీడియో చూపించాను. కనిపిస్తా ఉందా వీడియో? క కనిపిస్తా ఉందా వీడియో? సార్ ఒకసారి కనిపిస్తుంది, వీడియో కనిపిస్తుందా మీకు?
చూసేదోడు
with the help of books that place the cross section that is watch class on
madam sound madam video sound
value sir madam sir cheppandi
సౌండ్ రాలేదు మేడం, అంతేనా వీడియో? అది
సౌండ్ రాలేదా? ఉంది సార్, నాకు వినిపిస్తా ఉంది.
పిల్లలకు
వినిపిస్తుందా? ఎవరైనా చెప్పండి.
సూర్య
వినిపించలేదు మేడం.
సూర్య అన్మ్యూట్ చేసుకో.
వినపడలేదు మేడం.
వినపడలేదా? ఒక నిమిషం.
లేదు మేడం.
ఇప్పుడు
లేదు మేడం.
సార్ నాకు మాత్రమే వినిపిస్తా ఉంది సార్.
మీరు హెడ్సెట్ పెట్టుకో ఉండారు మేడం, మీకు మాత్రం వినపడుతుంది.
అవును సార్, అందువల్ల వినిపిస్తుందా?
లేదు మేడం.
ఇప్పుడు సార్ సరేలేండి సార్, ఈ వీడియో అయిపోయిన తర్వాత ఎంజాయ్ చేయండి సార్.
సరే మేడం.